My name's Chris Cooper. I'm from London, Ontario. And this is my chopper, Spike Reborn. The spike comes from basically anywhere we could put a spike on the bike, we put a spike from custom made axle nuts, springer nuts. We put spike grips, spike forward controls, spike pegs, motor mount, seat post spikes. I wanted something that was low in the back and sat high in the front. I wanted an aggressive riding position, and that's just easy to get when you have a drop seat bike. So before I started the build, I showed up at my friend Dave Green's shop at Rotten Choppers in Elmer, Ontario, and he had this cool looking bike, Spike Reborn, or actually it was called Spike. And I told him that was the exact frame that I was looking for. I couldn't find one. He made me an offer. He said, well, I'll sell you the frame. I'll take my bike apart, build another one. You can have the frame for your build. Spike Reborn has a 127-inch Ultima motor, show polished, RevTech 6-speed transmission, 80-spoked wheels, powder-coated rims, chrome spokes and hubs, has a 21-inch front wheel. It has performance machine brakes, front and rear. The gas tank was made by Dave from Fuel Fabrications and finished by me in-house. Has a 4.5-inch headlight. The Springer front end is actually a prototype front end. It's called the Raptor, and it was designed by me and Terry Vandenberg from Maple Leaf Customs. Has a spiked, kind of a spiky, tribally design in the top and bottom trees in the center brace. We chose to not use a fender on the bike. Dave Green, when he had Spike, actually had two seat posts made with spikes on the end. And it actually worked out perfectly when I was ready to start my build because it just went with the whole theme that I was going with. The rear wheel is 80-spoked, obviously matches the front. 18-inch rim, 250 tire. It has BDL hand controls. We made the handlebars in-house. They're just regular V-bars. It has a BDL 3-inch belt drive. The rotors and sprocket are custom cut from Hammer Cycles. Again, kind of flowing with the whole spike design. The frame is a twisted chopper's frame, 38 degrees, 6 up, 4 out. The seat was also made by Dave Green from Rotten Choppers. The forward controls are spike controls from Alex at XO Products in California. I wanted something that was a little bit different than what you typically see on choppers these days. A lot of them have rounded tanks. I wanted something that had a lot of sharp lines, again, that flowed with the spike theme of the bike. So I work with Dave from Fuel Fabrications in the States to build a really cool looking tank. The tank holds about 4 gallons. We finish it off in-house with a claw-like tip that kind of flows with the Raptor front end. Almost looks like the tank is two claws holding the frame. The rest of the fabrication was done in-house by me and my friend Steve and Darren. People are always asking me if it's hard to ride being a hardtail and having a Springer front end and all, but surprisingly enough, with a Springer front end, you get a little bit more bounce down the road. I won't lie, you get to learn where the bumps are and you learn what roads to stay off of. With a 3.5 to 4 gallon fuel tank, I can usually make it to the beach, which it's about a 40 minute drive. I can get to the beach and back, zip around town for a couple hours, and then I'm ready for another fill up. So as far as mileage goes, I don't do too bad considering.